In this video, I'm going to show you how to make an armchair. Now, I've actually made quite a few cakes where people have asked me to put figures sat in armchairs. So, for this one, we're going to do a brown leather one. Now, I've dyed some fondant brown, and it is just normal fondant that I've got. If you find that yours is a bit warm and sticky, or too soft to model with, just add a bit of modelling or flour and gum paste to it, and it should stiffen it up. Okay. Now, I've got quite a large amount here. I probably won't need it all, but I've dyed more than I need just in case. So I'm going to cut a small amount off. You'll see I haven't mixed the colours together very well because it looks a bit marbled in the middle, so I'll just give that a bit more of a mix. And what I'm going to do is start with a ball shape, which I'm then going to squash down, and I'm going to squash it on all four sides. So you might find it easier to roll a piece and cut it into a bit of a square shape, but because I want my edges to be quite rounded, I'm just doing it by hand. So just continually squashing it down and then just making sure you're getting those edges quite flat. And this is the very bottom bit of our sofa. Okay. Now, what I've done is just torn off a little bit of greaseproof paper so that I can put my sofa on here and move it around without moving it out of shape as I'm going along. Okay, so this is the very base. Bear in mind, whatever size you do your very base, it's going to be bigger because we're going to add arms to it, so it will get wider. So I'm just working those edges just a little bit. Like this, so you might find it much easier to just cut it to shape. Okay, so that's our basic bottom bits. So we're going to take a little bit more and we're going to make the same shape again but slightly thinner to put on top of this one. So start with a smaller amount. If it's too big, you can cut it down. So we'll do the same again. Now, I'm not worrying too much if I get the odd crack, because what I'll do is I'll just make sure that the cracks go to the back. Okay, now I'm going to put that on top of there. I think it's going to be a bit tall for what I want, so I'm going to squash it down a little bit more, cut some off that I'm not going to need. So you'll see it's becoming a similar shape. Now, it's quite tall, so what I might even do, cut that bottom one down a little bit so that it's not as tall, because I don't want my chair to be really high up. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just put this one on its side and I'm just going to cut a bit off the bottom like that so it is much thinner, which I should have probably just done to start with. So if you want, you can use the one that you've just rolled to put on top, or you can even use the bit that you've cut off the bottom. Just smooth the edges. Basically, you don't want it to have a perfect join down the front, you want it to have kind of a bit of a gap. So I'll just rework this, as I think I've misshaped it a little bit when I cut the bottom bit off. So when you're happy that they fit together, I'm just going to put a little bit of water on the top of that one. Not too much. You can use the edible glue if you prefer. And we're just going to push that onto there like that. So what we're going to do now is give our sofa some arms. So I'm going to take some more of my fondant. And I'm going to roll it this time using my rolling pin. But I'm going to keep it nice and thick. Now, obviously depending on the width of your arms will depend on how thick it wants to be this way. Okay, so what I'm going to do is cut an edge along the bottom, which will be the bottom of my sofa arm, like so. Now, height again, it's up to you how tall you want your arms to be, but I'm going to add a cushion to the seat, which will come slightly higher up on my arm, and then I want my arm to come a little bit higher, so I think I'm going to cut it about here. Okay, so again, very basic shapes at the moment. So just hold it against, obviously it's too long at the moment, it does need cutting down. so you can see for size. And I think I'm going to cut it down just a little bit more, have it just a little bit shorter like that. Okay, and I'm going to cut one end like that, and now I want to hold it against the side of my sofa so I can see how long it needs to be, so it wants to be level with the back of your cushion there. So I'll just put an indentation in and cut that there like that. Okay, so we've got the side of our sofa like that. Now we're just going to make it exactly the same, so don't stick that on anything yet because we'll need it to compare the other one to. Okay, so when you've cut those, just hold them against the sides of your chair to check they look the right size. Okay, and again, when you're happy with them, just put a bit of water to the bottom and just push that on gently onto there like so. So I haven't put loads of water on, just a little bit. Okay, and what we can do now is using a stitching tool. So this is the stitching tool that I've got. It's just a PME one, which I just bought online. So what you can do is, I'll see if I can put that on its side just so you can see what I'm doing, is we can just add some stitching lines in to make it look a bit more realistic. Okay, so what we're gonna do is just run the tool along the edges anywhere that you would get stitching on your sofa. I'm not sure how well you'll be able to see it on the video. If you don't have one of these tools, you can just use a cocktail stick and just put lots of dots in a row in for the stitching, okay? Now, you might want to put a couple of little creases in with the other end of your tool, just so that it looks a bit more fabric-like, it's got a bit more movement in it. Again, you can put those in this bit as well. Okay, and again, if you want to put seams on this bit, you can do. So we're going to make the back of the sofa next. So taking some of your fondant, you're going to roll it. You can keep it quite thick. Right, so I've cut two edges. Just going to hold it against the back of my sofa. Mark on where the other arm is. Cut that. And then work out how tall you want it to be. I'm just going to have a look. I'm going to mark mine, I think, to about there. So I'll cut that bit off. So I've just rounded off the corners a little bit. And we're just going to stick that onto there with a little bit of water again on the bottom bit, not too much. And most of this back bit will be covered anyway, so you won't be able to see this really. Okay, so we're just going to push that on like so. What we're going to do now is add our cushions. So we'll start with one for the chair. So I'm just going to roll it out a little bit this time. I'm going to cut an edge for the front. If it's a bit thick for what you want in, just roll it again a little bit thinner. If it hasn't got perfectly straight edges, that's good because you want everything to be quite rounded on the edges, so it looks a bit more fabric-y. Okay, so I'm going to cut a rough shape out, which should hopefully be a little bit too big, and then I can cut it down to size. So if I put it against there, I can see how much I'm going to take off. Okay. Now I should probably have made my arms a little bit taller than what they are, because the cushion then fills up the whole chair. So if you find that your cushion's making it too tall, either make your cushion a little bit smaller, or if you're happy with it like that, you could use this bit as your cushion rather than adding another one. Okay, so what I've done to make my arms a little bit taller, I've just kind of squashed them down a little bit at the bottom, so these ones are a little bit narrower at the bottom than at the top. This bit now should fit in to there, And what I'm going to do is just round off my edges. And I'm going to run a seam down the centre. And then I'm going to put in some like lines for creases. Put them wherever you fancy. Put some on the seat so it looks like it's been a little bit worn. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to roll this bottom end a little bit thinner. Cut that back down. So it's easier for me to slot the cushion in at the back. So we'll put that. So I'm just pinch that down so it's thin at the back. Okay. If you don't want it to be thinner at the back, that's fine. Just whatever you think looks best. So you can, if you want, move your cushion a little bit further over than the other ones. And if you want it to look like it's been sat in, you can sort of push in a little bit in the centre, putting some more creases in so it looks a little bit worn. Like that. And then we're going to add a cushion for the back, and then we're going to put a couple on the arms. So for the back, we're going to roll it out. Again, you don't want it too thick. And we're going to cut out a rough shape. Sorry, I realise it's probably a bit high up on the camera for you to see. That should be a little bit too big. Okay, so what I'm going to do, mark on where my arms come to about there, and I'm just going to take a little bit out of that, so a little rectangle out of each bit so that it slots into the chair a little bit better, or hopefully it will slot into the chair a little bit better. Yep, so that'll go onto there like that. And what you want to do now is just bring a little mark on the back that's a similar height to the back of your sofa. Okay, and we're just going to cut pretty much along that line, and I'm going to try and cut it with a slight curve on the top. So I don't know if you can see that, so it's got a slight curve on the top, so it's a little bit more cushioned shaped. And what I'm going to do is just press down those edges with my fingers so they become nice and rounded. Like that. Okay. And what we're going to do again is add a seam using our stitching tool along that top and side edge. It just looks a little bit more sofa-like. And again, you can add some little creases to your sofa using the other end of your tool. Add some big ones into the middle if you prefer. And you're just going to put a bit of water on the back. Not too much that it soaks it. You can always use royal icing as well if you don't want to use water or edible glue. So that's just slotted into there like so. I'm just going to push that in there. And we just now need a couple of bits for the arms. Now, if you like the arms as they are, you can leave them as they are. That's fine. Or if you want, we can roll out some more. And what I'm going to do is roll it so it's slightly thinner at one side than the other. It doesn't want to be too thick for both the arms. So I'm going to cut like that. Now it is a bit of guesswork. So I'm just going to cut a little rectangle off to start with. And I'm going to put it against there. So I can see size-wise if it's the right size for what I need. So it's about the right size actually, is that. So I'll just make sure the other one is similar in size. This one looks like it might be a little bit wider. Okay, so again, you're going to round off the edges. You don't want them too sharp. And I'm just going to pinch one edge so it's a little bit thinner than the other edge. So you're going to take your stitching tool and we're going to run it along the edges. And again, putting in little crease lines on the arms. Of water onto the back, and you're going to start by putting the thin end into the sofa, and then you're just going to bend it round and over your arm. So same again with this one, and that's it finished. So I'll try lift it up obviously let it set a little bit. And you can do different variations, and you don't have to do a single chair, you can do like a full sofa. So I'll put some pictures of a couple of others that I've done, just to give you some ideas. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more, please click on the images of the other videos suggested. Also, please do subscribe to my channel using the button at the bottom right hand corner of the screen. You can also visit my cake website and my Facebook page to see more cakes and ideas.